everybody, it's Professor Williams, and today we're going to look at the levels of data. We can also look at this as the scale of measurement of data. You'll remember that we have variables that are either qualitative or quantitative. And those qualitative variables are going to be the variables that have values that simply indicate what category an element belongs to, as opposed to our quantitative variables, which are numerical and represent the quantities that we have. Data is generally classified into four levels, or on a scale of four types. For the qualitative variables, our data will either be nominal or ordinal. When we have quantitative variables, that will be either interval or ratio level data. Let's take a look at what each one of these levels or the scale looks like. So when we have a nominal level variable, right, there's no meaningful order or ranking of the categories. So this could be jersey numbers for football players. It could be colors, could be makes or brands of automobiles. The secret here is that we have these categories, but there's no logical or no one order or rank for those categories that makes any more sense than the next. Now, when we get to these ordinal level variables, they're still qualitative, but now there's a meaningful order or rank of the categories. In other words, we can look at our metals here. So silver, bronze, and gold. We know gold is better than silver. Silver is better than bronze. We have small, medium, large, or we have like a five-star rating where we rate something from 1 to 5 stars. So these are still simply categories, but there is an order or rank that makes sense for those categories. Once we move into quantitative variables, we have two different levels as well. These interval level variables are variables where the ratio of the values aren't meaningful, and there is also no meaningful value of zero. There are very few types of interval level variables. Three of the most common are elevation. As we see in the picture, we see that the city of New Orleans is actually below sea level. So that idea of zero doesn't mean that there's no elevation, right? Zero in terms of elevation simply means at sea level. Another good example is temperature, right? So when we look at the thermometer, we see that zero is simply another measurement along the scale. Same goes for clothing size. We now have a size zero, which doesn't mean that someone is wearing zero clothes. It simply means that it's an extremely small size. So if we define zero as meaning the absence of a characteristic, interval level variables contradict that traditional meaning of zero, and zero simply becomes another measurement on the scale. And last but not least are ratio level variables. And these are quantitative variables where the ratio is meaningful and zero actually means zero. Zero means nothing. So some examples of this are weight, time, distance, money. In other words, when I talk about this ratio being meaningful, I know that 30 minutes is twice as long as 15 minutes. 160 pounds is twice as much as 80 pounds. 10 miles is 5 times as far as 2 miles. And so the majority of the data that we deal with in both descriptive and inferential statistics are these ratio level variables. As always, I hope that you found this useful, and thanks for watching.